Hello and welcome to the review video of Mega Video Robot. I do apologise, I didn't get this out as soon as the product came out. So you can buy this product for about $40. There's currently an offer on, you can get it for $30. And it is a good product. Don't be put off by this garish purple. It is a good product. I've just finished building a explainer video of just over a minute, and that's on YouTube. Let's talk about how we can produce this video. So if we go to produce, we can output in under HD, or we can output at 720, or we can go and output the file in 4K. You can select your frames per second and you can increment them up and down in one frame per second. So if you want to have a look at this video, I'm going to put a card up in the top right hand corner of the screen so you can go and see what we can produce with Mega Video Robot. So you add slides, and it's a slide based piece of software really. When we start a new project, we can pick the style of slides we want, and I'll come to that in a moment. And once you've added a slide, you can change the slide's duration here by moving it up and down. You can change the transition, you can change what goes on it as well. So this is incredibly similar and it's pretty much the same product as Animaytor, and I've done a review of Animaytor here, so I'm not going to go into as much detail today. So let's click here and look at transitions. So if we go to transitions, you need to pay for an upgrade to be able to have anything but a GIF animation. So I'm going to look just at the GIF animation. So we click here, and there are really good GIF animations. So let's just pick this blue water one here. One of the things I will mention about this software, and it's the same in Animaytor, is it's slow to load the assets. I don't know why, but it is slow to load the assets. So let's pick this blue water one. So we just click OK and it previews, and we can either apply it all to, or we click OK. So it adds here. So I'm just going to play this. So that's a good transition. So you can add in videos. So you would need to put your own video in. Videos aren't included, but you can add in videos, which is really useful. When it comes to sounds, you can add in sounds for slides, and they're things like sound effects. So when things appear, you can have sound effects syncing with those appearances, and you can add in music. So to add music, we go and select which one we want. You just double click it, and you can have it looping. So if the music is shorter than the duration of the project, you can click looping and it will just keep on going, which for these sort of things is really useful. This is probably the main one, images. So you add images and you go to add, and we've got buttons, quite a lot of characters, don't seem to have any cutouts, we have effects, we have a lot of graphics, we have overlays, we have social media stuff, and we have shapes. So shapes are quite good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a shape and I'm going to add some coffee. So I click here and I want to flip that. Now, unfortunately, I don't know if it has flipped. So I need to go past the transition. So it has flipped, here it is, but it flips vertically, and sometimes you just want to flip it horizontally. Well, you can't do that, unfortunately. So I'm going to take the flip off, and it's going to go, I'm going to put it over this side and I'm going to make it bigger. So I quite like adding these shapes. They're quite useful. There we are. So I'm going to go back to image and I'm going to add another one, and I'm going to go for that coffee cup. Where was it in graphics? Here we go. So now I'm going to animate them in. And this is where this software is really good, because it does make things look very professional. We can have it appear. I like a fly in. We can appear its direction it comes from. I'm going to have right to left, and we can go for how many milliseconds. I'm going to go for 500, and we can have it leave again. And I like to have it leave by the same mechanism. So I'm going to click OK, and that adds it in. So we can position it wherever we want. So I'm going to take the transition off. That will just make it easier to see. So I'm going to put the cursor here and I'm going to play it. So you could see it pops in really quickly and it pops out. And what I can do down here is I can change the duration. So I can change how long it's on screen for by dragging here. And I can also change its duration for in and out. So let's have a look at this. I'm going to have this have a really small in and out for this shape. So that looks really professional how that works, really professional. And I've been able to build loads and loads of slides together, and it does look like a professional piece of explainer video. You'll notice you'll hear the sound. So the sound is on loop. So if I keep adding, if I keep making my project longer, the sound expands as well. So that's really good. We can also add in text. So just going to type in this is text. And again, we have the same effects of going in and out. I'm going to do top to bottom 500. I'm going to put a shadow on it, and I can also put a text highlight. What a text highlight does is it just puts it in a block. So I'll show you that. So here's our text. This is test. I can put it up here. I can have it come in, etc. If I double click it and I put this in, probably better to go for maybe a nice blue and take that shadow off. There we are. So it just puts it within a box basically, and I can change the size of the box if I want to. So these are the backgrounds we can pick. This one looks quite good. Oh, lovely. It doesn't move, it's just a picture. And then themes, we can have this type of theme. The chalkboard's pretty good. Electric, we've got lots of themes. And what happens with the themes is when you add a different slide, you get a different color. So if I click this blue streak and I apply, then if I go and add a different slide, I get the same color. But if I change the theme to Showtime, then I get the same throughout. So I don't really like that, but I'm going to cancel it. It's actually really good. We can produce videos in 4K. We can have things move in and out. I'm going to talk now about the drawbacks. So let's go here and go to image. The drawbacks are as follows. When we have these loads, they load really slow, and scrolling through them is very slow. Whether that is characters or that is buttons and things, overlays. When we have lots of them, they are very slow to keep loading. Now, obviously, you can see I don't have lots of them. What I'm showing you here is what you get in the basic package. But in Animaytor, where I've bought the Maximizer, it's very slow. And I suspect, as it's pretty much the same here, it's going to be very slow as well. The other thing is it's really time consuming when you add lots and lots of images and text. It's really time consuming to put in all the appearances and stuff. There's no way to do it in bulk, or there's no way to treat them all the same. Really, when I'm doing something like this, I like all the things to come in together and all the things to go out together. There isn't a way to do that. You can add a script and you can do text to speech, which is fantastic. All of these softwares now seem to do text to speech. That's great. And you can sync up your voiceover and your text to speech with where the slides start and end. That's a little bit difficult, so I'm not going to show you that, but it is possible. It is fiddly. And you can also record a voiceover, and you can also upload a voice track if you want to. So Mega Video Robot, I think it's really good. I think it's very well priced. You get some assets. If you want to upgrade, you can get more assets. You might find the upgrade is not worth it though, considering what you get for such a low amount of money. Do check out my Animaytor video, because that goes into much more detail, and I hope to have a Maximizer upgrade video out soon. Thank you. Goodbye.